Hi everyone, in this video you will learn about the Organic Rankine Cycle ORC working fluid selection criteria. The choice of the organic working fluid is the most important item to consider for the design and operation of the ORC. There are hundreds of suitable pure substances and mixtures that can be adopted as the working fluid option for the organic Rankine cycle. One may be confused about the organic fluid to go with during the selection process. Hence, it is important that we create a list of criteria to guide our considerations from the many potential organic fluids. First on my list, we need to consider the heat source temperature, whether the heat source is the waste heat from a heat engine, biomass, or solar heat source. This temperature has an effect on the overall system performance and cycle efficiency, as the cycle efficiency of the Carnot cycle is a function of the maximum temperature and the heat sink temperature. Of course, one may ask, would superheating the ORC be beneficial? The answer is there is no benefit for superheating the ORC fluid. Another important point about the heat source temperature is that it would have a knock-on effect on the component design, especially the turbine design, as this will determine the speed of revolution, dimensions, number of stages, and the turbine isentropic efficiency. Second is the thermodynamic and heat transfer properties of the organic fluid. To be specific, we are interested in organic fluid with large enthalpy of vaporization, which means the fluid has the ability to give off lots of its energy as it expands through the turbine. We also need an organic fluid with high boiling point and high specific volume at low temperature condensation, which means we can get more power from the system with high boiling point and high specific volume at low temperature condensation. We also need an organic fluid with high molecular mass, which would allow small enthalpy drop during expansion, and an organic fluid with low viscosity. Number three is the chemical reactivity of the organic fluid to the component material. This is so important because we need an organic fluid that is chemically stable for the component material, and from system perspective, instability could be a strong source of irreversibility. We need an organic fluid that is relatively non-corrosive. Number four is the environmental and legislation concerns. The environment is so important to us, especially with the numerous environmental disasters we've seen in many places in the past 10 years. We want an organic fluid that is non-toxic to the environment, relatively non-corrosive both to component materials and human operators. And we need a fluid that will not add burden to ozone depletion. In terms of legislation, we want an organic fluid that does not have several regulations and restrictions in terms of fluid handling. Hence, this will become more of an operational challenge. And number five is the cost. As engineers, we're not only looking at the system performance, so we don't end with a design that a finance guy would not want to invest in. Hence, we need to do due diligence in terms of the organic working fluid cost, which is a component of the overall capital and operating costs. We want to use an inexpensive organic fluid that would also meet the system performance requirement. It becomes a tricky one because you have cost on this side and system performance on the other side. So as an engineer, your goal is to be somewhere in between a reasonable cost and reasonable system performance. This would mean that we look for an organic fluid that is readily available, that is, a fluid that is in abundance. We need an organic fluid that is readily available, as the availability of the organic fluid will have a knock-on effect on the cost of the organic fluid vis-a-vis the operating cost of the plant. And these are the factors I think you need to consider when selecting organic fluid for the ORC. Maybe I may have missed others. Please let me know other factors you think I may have missed in the comment section below this video. I strongly want to know your thoughts on other factors. I hope you find this video useful. If this video was useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to see more of my videos like this. Thank you for watching and see you on my next video.